pretty fantastic to catch up with the LA Rams, made the playoffs last year, and then decided, let's change quarterbacks. They traded for Matt Stafford, who can absolutely spin it. And, of course, we are so honored to be joined by Andrew Whitworth, who he has been playing this game a long, long time. And you played against Dan Campbell.
Right? Oh, yeah.
And so Dan Campbell's now the head coach of the Detroit Lions. Obviously, everybody had fun with his, and we're gonna
kneecaps, right?
Yeah, we're gonna bite your kneecaps, yeah. Right? This was Dan Campbell earlier today.
Normally, what I do is I'll get two venti. I go to, you know, Starbucks. I get two venti of the pipe with two shots in them. So black eye in both. That's what I come in with. That's how I start the day. So
I like the sound effects. Probably even add to it even more. 39 years old. Not your first. Not your first rodeo. What do you do to get up in the morning to get yourself ready?
Not that, I'll tell you that much. I don't know if I could withstand that. That's a lot of pressure right there with the caffeine. But no, for me, I mean, it's getting up and getting active. Usually in the mornings, I do some kind of fasted cardio or just a little walk or something just to get me going and try to get up a little early enough to where I can do that, kind of catch a sweat, and then head to meetings and all that good stuff. And
you don't care, you don't have like a little dog, do you? Like I can't see you, you know, walking with like a little Pomeranian or something.
No, I'll do either some kind of walk on the treadmill or some backwards walking or stuff, just get the legs active, and then some kind of little, you know, couple rounds or something, 20 minutes, 15 minutes, getting the sweat going, getting the heart rate up a little bit. Just not enough to wear me out, but just enough to get me woke up and ready to ride.
You've been doing this a long time. Actually, been doing this with the Rams for a good amount of time. And obviously, you guys have had some different machinations of the offensive line. How's the group so far?
Man, it's been great. It's really fun. We got a lot of guys that have, you know, fortunately, when you go through some of these tough times in the league like we had in 2019, where we got guys getting hurt over and over and over again, you know, and you're playing a lot of guys, it comes to fruition when those guys are really young and that was their first ever experience playing. Now here you are a couple years later and we got a situation where we've got all these guys that have all played in the game. They've all got live reps. They've all had a chance to kind of grow in the league and grow up themselves, and they're all in that third, fourth, fifth year. You know, it's fun. I mean, we probably have eight guys that you're like, man, this guy could play and help us. And so it's really finding that great mix and what we feel good about. And I think all of us feel pretty confident that we have a lot of guys that could play in a football game and help us win.
You've obviously done very well financially, done great on the football field, a four-time Pro Bowler, two-time first-team All-Pro. Has there been a morning that you've gotten up in training camp thinking, I don't know, what am I doing? What am I doing?
That's about every day of my life playing football. So I don't know if there's a day that that's not a feeling. You know, that's the life of being an offensive lineman and being a tackle especially, right? I mean, the reality is this. Like I always tell people, you think of the greatest player in the world on defense. I'm going to call him Aaron Donald because I really believe he is.
Yeah.
You know, you think of the reality is this guy wins, you know, I don't know, one out of 50 rushes a game or two out of 50 rushes a game. He's a surefire Hall of Famer. And he's going to lead the NFL in the history of sacks. But as an NFL offensive lineman, you lose two pass reps a game, you'll never see another season in the NFL. You won't make it through one season. So whereas we need to win 98, 99% of our reps, the opposite side of the ball only needs to win one or two. And so the reality of our game is you're constantly just having to be tough enough to realize I'm going to mess up, but I got to be as consistent as possible and have a really tough mindset that I got to win a lot. I can't just win once. And so that mentality, you got to be used to having a little bit of failures, beating yourself up a little bit and continuing to grind.
You know what it's like? I mean, this is, I don't know if you've ever heard this metaphor. I just thought of it when you were talking. It's kind of like the airlines with baggage, right? Like you got millions of people flying, but you lose somebody's bag
one time
and you're the worst. Or your flight is delayed one time. People start tweeting like, I can't believe this airline. You're like, look, dude, we got a lot of things going on here. It's just one time. You've protected a lot of really good quarterbacks. You know, Carson, even Fitz is still slinging. He's still playing. Obviously, out here, Goff, the past couple years. What's it been like early on with Stafford?
Well, I think you really just see that veteran presence that we've talked about. I mean, you can't replace playing that long in the game. And everything is just so natural. He feels it. He understands the game. He's really smart. He's played enough to have seen it all, you know. And in one way, form, or fashion, he's seen all the different looks you're going to give him. It might be a little nuance that's different, but he's got a feel for it. And so playing with a guy like that who can absolutely spin it, and then he's matched up with, you know, in a relationship there with Sean McVay and the way that guy's mind thinks, and they can really pull off of each other. I just think that is a great mix for Los Angeles Rams, that is for sure, because those two really together is going to make this thing pretty special.
You mentioned Sean, and we just had him on, and we talked about how he doesn't really like to play starters at all in the preseason games. But he's kind of changed football with his approach to these games. How is it? So what is it really like in a preseason game week that he started and that other people have kind of followed?
Well, I would argue it's almost more intense than probably when I got in the league in 06 to 2011 when you did play in the preseason games. You know, you almost kind of were excited once the preseason game started because the first couple, 2-3 weeks of camp were all two-a-days. They were all banging heads. And then you get to the preseason, it's like, all right, let's back it down to more of a normal game week. And then we're going to just prepare you guys body-wise to play in the game. And you might play 10 plays, you might play 20, but it's still not much of a workload. Whereas here, we're really like, we're just ignoring the fact there's a preseason game and we just prep ourselves and get ready and you know, we scrimmage against each other, we compete, and we just can constantly have situations where we're having competition periods, competition moments in practice that create and make us better. And I think that's the focus, is really just worry about ourselves, don't worry about other teams, don't worry about game planning, don't worry about any of that. Let's find out how good we can be during training camp, and then when the season rolls out, we'll let it fly.
You know, when you're in Cincy, at first it was bad, obviously. Then, you know, when Andy came in, You guys playoffs 5 years in a row, right? So you've been through the ups, you've been through downs. But I do wonder, when you walk into a locker room or you're around a group, do you know early in the season, like, this could be a special group? Or does it take actual game reps to know what a team is capable of?
Yeah, I mean, I think we have a special locker room, a special culture, and a special atmosphere with Sean McVay. I mean, the reality is we kind of feel like we're in every game and we have a chance to compete regardless of the opponent or the situation and every season. I mean, you really look at even in 2019, you know, we're one win away from making the playoffs in a situation where we're constantly losing people up front. We're playing with guys who've never even played in a football game before in their life in the NFL and the offensive line. And then also, you really look at some of those games early in the year, some teams kind of changed how they played us and came up with new inventions, and then by the end of the year we had it figured out, and you know, just wish we wouldn't have ran out of games to get in. And so I think it's one of those things where, you know, this team and this atmosphere that we have here, we feel like we can compete with anybody any week, and so it's about going out and executing it. And this team's not any different. I think with some of the additions and some of the people that we have that are going to step up in that next moment in their career this year as they're aging and getting better and understanding the game more, I think we're as confident as ever.
You mentioned Aaron Donald. I mean, widely regarded as the best player in football. What is he like to line up against? And obviously, you guys, they try and keep you guys away from each other in the preseason. But as an all-time great pro, to watch an all-time great pro at his craft, what makes him so special from your perspective?
Well, I think it's really that it's one of those rare things, and you know, you see it in sports. There's different guys that you can kind of peg in every different professional sport where you go, you know, talent meets work ethic, meets example and leadership, and that's what Aaron Donald is. He's this generational talent. He's got a really, really ability, his strength, his speed, his reaction skills are elite, but also his work ethic and the attitude that he approaches every single day with, the effort level he plays with day in and day out. Doesn't matter if it's a walkthrough, doesn't matter if it's a practice, doesn't matter if it's against us, against another team, it doesn't matter the moment. He's going to compete at a level where everybody's just trying to see if they can somewhat keep up with him. And so when you match that kind of talent with that kind of ability to work hard and that kind of attitude of, hey, you know what, I don't care how many player of the years I've won, I don't care how good people think I am, I'm going to work harder than every single person on this field, you're going to get a really rare player in any sport, and he is that example.
When you decide I'm done, you walk away, you still going to watch? You're going to miss it? Or are you just going to completely get away for a period of time?
I'll say this. I've never been a big watcher of the game. So, like, even when I played in college, like, you know, like, people even now will be like, man, well, did you see who LSU's playing or whatever? It's like, man, LSU was great. I really enjoyed it. I don't give a crap who they're playing or what they're doing. Like, I really don't. So, you know, it's one of those things. It's fantastic. I wish them the best. I'm not going to watch every game. Like, I just not that important. I got kids, a wife, other things to do, golf. You know, I got my own things I like to do, but I love the game, like the actual intricacies of the game. So, like, I like studying why somebody's special or what makes them good, or defenses, offensive coaches, you know, really what is it that makes them tick? What is it makes them special, what they do? I love that part of the game more so than sitting at home rooting for somebody. I've never been a big cheerleader. So
like, one of the great things about the offensive line, the lineman room, is that you guys, there's always a spit cup, right? has to be spit cups. I don't know how many spit cups they got in your room, but a lot of exceptionally bright guys sitting around talking, watching ball. You've been doing this your entire professional life. Smartest guy you ever played with is who?
John Sullivan, no question. Center we had here with the Rams for a couple of years there, even in our Super Bowl season as well, and smartest player by far. And you know what? Actually, neither one of us had spit cups. So you know,
how can you have played at LSU and not been a spit cup guy?
I am probably the least Southern Louisiana kid in America. So I was the kid growing up going like, I am looking for a high rise or a beach. Like, get me the heck out of this place.
Well, so, we got high rises, we got beaches, and you've decided to stay a while. That's a good thing.
That's why I'm not going anywhere. I can assure you that.
Well, we got to get you out of the valley in Thousand Oaks and get you down here where there's no heat, right? Yeah. You got this nice breeze.
I'll go visit Louisiana when the bugs are down and it's a little cooler. Maybe like November.
Yes.
Okay? I'll make a run down there and
November
say hello.
November or late February, early March, right?
Just long enough to eat something fried and something that's really bad for me, and then I'm getting the heck out of town.
Okay, when you go back, one thing fried, what is it that you like to eat?
You know, I mean, you got to have a shrimp po' boy. If I make like a fried shrimp po' boy, oh man, a little mayo, tomato, and lettuce on there. Maybe even a little cheddar cheese, you know, depending on your mood. And maybe even a little spicy chipotle mayo sometimes. Yeah, mix it up a little bit.
They do not have those in Thousand Oaks. No chance.
Not much of that. No.
No, not much of that. Wiz, thanks so much for stopping by. Can't tell you how much we appreciate it, and we look forward to seeing you play this year. SoFi State, brand new, like, that place is crazy, isn't it?
I can't wait, man. It's going to be insane. I imagine the goosebumps will be at a whole other level walking into that place against the Chicago Bears.
Thanks for joining us.
Hey, appreciate you.
Andrew Whitworth, straight off his walk. He did the backwards walk over here to kind of get the body
That's it.
get the body moving.